Hey everyone, this is JustaTech and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I will show you a latest way to jailbreak your passcode or a disabled iPhone or iPad running on the iOS 14.8 lower to the iOS 12, include iOS 13 also. You can follow the same procedure for passcode device, or if you have a disabled screen device, you can follow the same process and jailbreak your device very easily. I will show you the complete tutorial like how you can do that. And if I talk about the compatibility of the devices, like which iPhones and iPads are supported, if you have a A10 and lower devices that are supported, like iPhone 7 Plus, iPhone 7, iPhone 6s, iPhone 6s Plus and lower models are supported, and iOS 14.8 and lower are supported, because currently the iOS 14.8 are latest that are supported with the checkerin jailbreak. iOS 15 is currently not supported, so whenever the checkerin will support the iOS 15, this method will work for iOS 15 as well, but currently the iOS 14.8 and lower are supported. First of all, you will require the Mac operating system, or if you are a Windows user, you can run the Hackintosh as well to do the following process. I have already made the several videos like how you can set up the Hackintosh on your Windows machine to run the Mac. So first of all, I will open the checkerin latest version, that is the 0.12.4. Now I will talk about the what are the problems in the jailbreak of the disabled or a passcode device. Currently I have an iPhone 6s that is running on the latest 14.8 and it's on the passcode mode. So whenever I connect my device with a PC and the checkerin doesn't detect the device as it's on the passcode or a disabled mode and the USB restrictions is on, and if you talk about the 3U tools and the iTunes, as it will not directly detect by the PC, as you have to connect your device into the DFU mode or a recovery mode, and then it will show on the checkerin screen or 3U tools or the iTunes. But for jailbreaking this device, you are required to do some following steps. First, I will completely turn off my device and put my device into the recovery mode. I have an iPhone 6s, so the recovery mode option is very simple. If you have a other device like iPhone 7 and 7 Plus, the button combination is different. For this device, I have a physical home button, so I will just turn it off and put my cable inside, and after that I will press the home button continuously and it will put directly my device into the recovery mode. But as if you have a other device like iPhone 7 or 7 Plus that doesn't have the physical home button, it has a sensor button, so you will require the different button combination to put your device into the recovery mode. So now as you can see, my device is into the recovery mode and the checkerin also detect my device, and you can see the iTunes pop-up is also there. Now I will give you the brief idea like what we will do in a minute. Like between the jailbreak process, we need to put your device into the special mode, that is the diagnostic mode, you can say the Apple diagnostic mode, that has the special button combination to put into that mode. So for the iPhone 6s, iPhone 6s Plus, the button combination is home button and the volume up button, continuously pressing that, and after that your device into the diagnostic mode. But for the iPhone 7, 7 Plus and iPhone 8, 8 Plus, you will require to press the volume down and volume up button. So for this method, the iPhone 6s, 6s Plus, iPhone 7, 7 Plus are supported. Currently the A11 devices are not supported, that include the iPhone 8, 8 Plus and iPhone X. So make sure that you will require the correct device to do the following step. So as I told you, the iPhone 7, 7 Plus has a button combination to put your device into diagnostic mode, that is the volume up and volume down, continuously pressing that for the 10 second or 15 second and it will put your device into that mode. And for the iPhone 6s or iPhone 6s Plus, that is the home button and the volume up button. So I've told you each and everything. Now I will put my device into that mode and proceed further to the jailbreak part. Now next, you need to connect your device into recovery mode and click on the options and allow the untested iOS version for the latest iOS version, and after that simply click on start and put your device into the DFU mode. Follow the instruction on the screen. Now once you see the checkerin is start jailbreaking your device, at the time quick fast press the home button and the volume up button to put your device into DFU mode. So just pressing that for the 15 to 20 second, and after that you will see the all done on the checkerin screen and your device into the diagnostic mode. As I told you, this is only for the 6s and 6s Plus. For the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus, the button combination is different. For that, you need to press the volume up and volume down as per that model. Alright, now we are in the diagnostic mode, and you can see on the screen of the device it's showing the diagnostic mode is on, but sometimes the checkerin GUI version doesn't work or it's stuck on the booting screen. On that situation, you can run the check rain in CLI mode. This trick is only for those who are facing issue in the GUI version of the check rain. Then you can run the check rain in the CLI mode and jailbreak from the command line terminal. So it's very easy. I will show you how you can do that. So it's very easy. You have to go to the Finder application. Then you will find the check rain app. Right click on it, show the package content. After that, go to the macOS folder where you will find the check rain file. Now open the terminal, drag and drop the check rain file on the terminal. Now press the spacebar and type the -c. You have to type the -c and click on enter, and it will run the check rain in the CLI mode. After that, put your device into the DFU mode like you do in the GUI mode. And then after the booting stage, you have to press the diagnostic button combination, that is the home button and the volume up button. Now you can see your jailbreak is done and your device is getting into diagnostic mode. So this is the second way. If the GUI version get failed, you can try the CLI mode and jailbreak your device into the diagnostic mode. And as I told you, for the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus, the diagnostic mode button combination is volume up and volume down. Now next, we need to patch the USB restriction for the device. So for that, we will use the HFZ USB patcher jailbreak tool. You will find the download link in the description. You can go to my blog and download all the links that are required in this video. So just simply install it on your system. Now after the installation, simply run the tool. Now before you use the tool, you need to register your device serial number in the tool. So I will show you how you can register that. And this is the tool interface. It's very easy to use. You have to jailbreak your device into diagnostic mode, and after the registration, you have to just click on start USB restrict and it will patch the USB restriction. And after that, you can normally jailbreak your device. And to register your device, you can go to the website and create your account and register your service in the USB patch of HFZ, or you can contact me from the Telegram, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and you can message me and register your device directly. So there are two ways. I will give the links in the description of all this, so you can register that directly from there. So now my device is successfully connected and showing the serial number. Now just click on start USB patch and it will start patching the USB restriction of that device. And after successfully message, you can normally jailbreak your device. Now you can see it showing successfully patched. So now I will move further to the normal jailbreak part. Now in the starting, I've shown you two ways to jailbreak. One is from the GUI mode and other is for the CLI mode from the check rain. So you can use any of them. You need to just re-jailbreak your device normally, and this time it will not stuck on the booting or showing you the -20 or 21 error, as this time we have successfully patched the USB restriction. So now I will just put my device into the DFU mode manually. So now as you can see, my device is getting into jailbreak state without I am putting into the diagnostic mode again, as the device restriction is patched now. So now you can normally jailbreak your device. Now as you can see, all done, that means the jailbreak is completed. Now the device is on, but it's currently in the disable mode, as I have tried so many wrong attempts of passcode. But it's my own device and I know the passcode of the device, but for showing you guys for the all the process, I put in the device into the disable mode. So now I will unlock my device. After the 5 minutes, I will show you the jailbreak is completed and the check rain app is in my home screen. So let's just wait to get out from the disable mode and then see the jailbreak is done or not. Now the device is again active, so I will enter my passcode. So now as you can see, the check rain loader is in my home screen. So now we have successfully jailbreak our passcode or a disabled device with the check rain loader with the HFZ USB patcher. So you can follow the same process for other iPhone models like iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. This is the same process, but the button combination is different to put your device into diagnostic mode. So that's all for this video. I hope you gained some knowledge, and if you like the content, just hit the like button, and if you're new here, just subscribe to the channel. So until then, goodbye, take care and peace out.